Alright. Honey came in and she got me red-handed, creeping with the girl next door. Picture this, so we were both club making love on the bathroom floor. How could I forget that I had given her an extra key? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me.
Oh, you bring out your woman access to your villa. Trust us on the weakness, all of your clean out your pillar. You better watch your back before she turn into a killer. Just review the situation that you call the peanut to be a true player.
Everybody in the studio is popping. Aiden's doing his low rider thing over there and stuff. That was, of course, the re-recorded hit single It Wasn't Me by Shaggy to welcome you back. And with a career spanning over two decades with hit tunes like Bombastic and Angel, it's clear that this man is still a musical force to be reckoned with.
So to celebrate the 20th anniversary of his landmark album Hot Shot, he's released a new album with fresh takes of his biggest hits. Pop sensation Shaggy joins us now on the line. But first, here's a reminder of the chart-topping tunes that shot him to fame.
Shaggy!
But you caught me on the counter.
Wasn't me.
Saw me kissing on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on camera.
No. She called me Mr. Bombastic, friendly fantastic. Put me on my box, she says I'm Mr. Roo. Romantic, call me fantastic. Put me on my box, she says I'm Mr. Roo.
But the feeling that I have for you is so strong. Been together so long and this could never be wrong.
Girl, you're my angel, you're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps, you are to me, baby.
Angel of Harlem.
Shaggy, you have
Shaggy,
the whole studio bopping and rocking and shaking booties this morning. And you're still doing it 20 years on. Good morning to you. Welcome.
Good morning, guys. It's amazing. Thanks for having me, man. Appreciate it.
You're very welcome. What time is it in Jamaica, Shaggy?
I think it's about probably around 5:30 now, I think.
Wow.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
20 years. Can you believe that it's 20 years, Shaggy, since they were all at their peak? Has it flown by?
Yeah, it does feel like time flies, you know, and that happens when you're having fun. It's been an amazing ride for me, man. And, when you do this for the love and you know, music is like air to me, and I still continue to do it and have fun doing it. And, you know, Hot Shot 2020 was such a monumental album for the genre of dancehall. And, you know, after 20 years, you know, Angel, It Wasn't Me, these songs were songs that gave us a seat at the table. These are the songs that really brought the genre to the mainstream. And, to celebrate it, we wanted to do like a remake of some of these songs. And there was so many kids doing TikTok to like It Wasn't Me and these songs. So I decided that I wanted to get some young producers and, you know, have them remake them in ways like with trap influences, reggaeton, Afrobeat, trap. And I really liked how they came out. So I ended up doing that with, you know, older songs like Mr. Bombastic and Old Caroline and these songs. And, so it's kind of a celebration of a journey of Shaggy through dancehall. And of course, we had such a great success this summer here with Banana, which is also on the album. So, you know, I just think it's a really great listen, especially in these times of COVID.
You mentioned the banana. The banana challenge is now a big thing on TikTok, which, of course, we were talking about earlier on. But, you know, you have to be part of that whole scene now, don't you, as a musician? I mean, there's so many different elements to it.
I'm a part of it, whether I like it or not. You know,
yeah.
These kids really embraced it. What I really love about the banana song is that the fact that every video that I see, people are super smiling and happy,
yeah.
You know, and it's a family affair and everybody gets down to it. And that's what I really, you know, if we're not doing that in music, especially in this time where everybody's all, it's such a rough time, it's such a hard time for everyone, but they get a smile on their face, they feel like it's great. And, you know, I've been here in Jamaica, and as much as we're quarantined and you know, we have these curfews and stuff, like everybody still have this kind of energy of life, you know, and this song really, really resonates with a lot of people, and I'm happy for that.
Do you find, Shaggy, that the collaboration process, has it changed over the 20 years? Like, you know, when you went back to revisit these songs and you know, said you were dealing with sort of young producers, like the technology, the things that these guys can do now with laying tracks and what they can do with editing, has it changed the collaboration process or is it still the same?
Well, it's everything is easier now. You know, yeah. At one time we used to fly to places and be in the room together. And then after a while, you still could, they'll track separately. But now you could even track on Zoom, while they're in the studio. There's so many ways to do it. And with technology now, everything used to be hardware. Now it's all software. And the drawback to that is, a lot of these younger kids, because of the technology, it makes them not try to perfect their craft because the technology is making them sound really good.
The technology solves the mistakes for them, Shaggy. Is that what you're saying?
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
So they're not making mistakes and learning the hard way like you did and we did.
Exactly. Yeah, and you got to perfect your craft in this because once it comes to live, and even now in live, a lot of these kids are not really doing it live. They're really just playing the track and being on top of it. So I think it's a cultural thing at this point. And I'm not knocking it. If it works for them, it works for them. But, for a person like me, I'm always trying to push the envelope and trying to better myself and trying to be on top of my game,
And Shaggy, can I ask you, just taking you back to when these now kind of iconic dance tracks dropped 20 years ago and you just kind of banged them out one after the other, you were everywhere, the awards shows, everything was happening. It was kind of a life of, fame and showbiz. Were you prepared for all of that?
I got prepared really quick. I learned very early that I was very, very fortunate because dancehall, when we came with Old Carolina, dancehall was not the type of art form that was on, it wasn't a genre that was on radio.
It didn't get played.
And the fact it was the mainstream. So the fact that I got in with Old Carolina, Old Carolina was the first British chart and dancehall number one. And I realized how big a deal that was. And I realized that I was now representing this genre. And so by the time they turned around, I came back with Bombastic, which was also it's the first reggae dancehall record to debut at number one, on the British chart. And at that point, I got ready really quickly and realized that, okay, I had to behave accordingly. I got to go. And I realized because I was the underdog, I had to do 10 things 10 times better. I had to make music 10 times better, go 10 times harder because it wasn't a level playing field. I had to really put in the work because I was now carrying a whole genre.
And in terms of the music industry and the music scene today, in 2020, who excites you at the moment? Do you sit there and think, God, I'd love to collaborate with him or with her? Who's on your playlist at the moment?
When it comes to collaboration, to be honest with you, I have kind of a track record. If you look at the patterns of things, I did It Wasn't Me with an unknown artist by the name of Rick Rock. I did Angel with another unknown artist by the name of Rayvon. I recently did, I Need Your Love with Mia Mohambi and Fady, two unknown artists again. And I'm now with another smash hit with another unknown artist, which is by the name of Conqueror. So I'm always about the integrity of the record more so than who the big star is. But there's a lot of people that excite me. I love Billie Eilish music. I'm also a guy that likes a lot of the old things, like Bill Withers is one of my favorite. In Jamaica, in the reggae scene, I love Coffee and I love what she's doing and the excitement she brings to the game. I love Shensia. Dexter Dapps is another dancehall artist that I like. So there are a lot of artists out there that I really dig and get into. Because I'm just a fan of music and I'm a fan of changing music and hybrids.
Well, look, we can't wait to get our hands on this album. It is out now, Shaggy.
It is out now. Make sure you go catch it. It's an amazing record. It's a good feel. It feels like you're on vacation when you listen to it. you know, it's got Sting on there. It's got a whole bunch of us that's really doing some amazing music. And, you know, I think you guys will enjoy it.
Well, God knows we could all do it a vacation right now, Shaggy, even if it's a virtual one. Listen, we appreciate you getting up in the middle of the night and taking the time to talk to us. Lovely to talk to you. And you look after yourself. Take care.
Stay safe, Shaggy.
Thank you, my brother. All the best, all the best.
Take care. Right.
Shaggy's album, Hot Shot 2020, is available now on all digital platforms.
Oh, he's so lovely, isn't he?
What a gent. Yeah.